I'll write down the heading here. In case of multi-cyclic compound, so if the compound has more than one ring present in the compound, so in this case we only count the number of the peripheral pi electrons. Okay, so we only count the peripheral pi electrons. So what is peripheral pi electrons? I'll tell you. Okay, suppose I'll take an example of naphthalene. This is an example of naphthalene. Okay. Or we can also draw the resonating structure of this one, which is nothing but we'll always try to take that resonating structure in which the pi maximum number of pi electron present in the peripheral thing. What is peripheral means? Peripheral means this thing. You start from any carbon atom and you are going along the boundary of the compounds. Like this. Along the boundary of the compounds. Okay. So this pi bond we are not counting. Okay. And we always try to draw maximum possible number of pi electrons along this boundary. Okay, so that is why I have drawn this resonating structure. Okay, so here you see the number of pi electrons are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 10 pi electrons. 10 pi electrons is aromatic for n is equals to 2. Okay, so this compound, which is naphthalene, the name of this compound is naphthalene, it is aromatic. Okay, so we'll see a few more examples and we'll see the application of this. How do we count the peripheral pi electrons? Okay, so these are the examples we are going to discuss. Okay, so how many pi electrons we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 10 pi electrons, so it follows Huckel's rule, aromatic in nature. Okay, here you see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Right? So it has 12 pi electrons. Okay? So with 12 pi electrons, what we can say? With 12 pi electrons, we can say that it is anti-aromatic because it has 4 n pi electrons following, right? So it is anti-aromatic in nature. Okay? Now in this one, I forgot to write down a double bond. This should be double bond. Okay, so how many pi electrons are there? 2, 4, 6, 8 pi electrons. This also follows anti aromatic compounds. Okay, here you see this carbon, this is the non peripheral pi electrons. Okay, so we call it as non peripheral pi electrons. We won't count this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 14 pi electrons it has. So it is aromatic in nature for n is equals to 3. Okay. This carbon atom, you see, these two are sp3 hybridized carbon. sp3 hybridized carbon. It is like this. Listen to me carefully over here. when we have a multicyclic system and any of the carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, then what we'll do, we'll see the smaller ring on from that. Okay, so we have two rings here. If you try to, you know, understand here, we have two rings. One is cyclobutadiene, you can say, and other one is this benzene ring. Okay, so since this two carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, so it is non-planar, right? It should be non-aromatic. But in case of multicyclic ring, what we do, we first, if you are getting non-aromatic, then we check the smaller ring. Okay, if it is non-aromatic, then we further check the smaller ring till we get the aromatic compounds. Okay, but here we have only two rings possible. So the first, the larger ring is this, the whole ring is this, larger ring is this, which is non-aromatic. So we'll check the smaller ring. Okay, a smaller ring is what? Then we have this benzene ring. First, the large ring is the whole compound, and then the smaller ring is what? The benzene ring, which is aromatic in nature. Hence, this molecule is aromatic compound with 6 pi electron. We'll see some more examples on this, then you will understand how to do this. Okay, just you have to keep in mind that we'll keep on looking at the ring, a smaller ring, till we get the aromaticity or aromatic ring. Okay, this thing we only do when we have non-aromatic compound. The larger ring is non-aromatic. Okay, so we'll keep on checking the smaller rings one by one. Okay, so like you see, for a few more examples, if I write down here this molecule, you see it is sp hybridized carbon, right? sp3, these are sp3. So the larger molecule is non-aromatic. Then we check the smaller one. A smaller one is what? This is the smaller ring we have, right? And this smaller ring, see, the smaller ring of this will be what? Cyclohexane. Large is this whole ring. The smaller of this will be this cyclohexane, which also has sp3. So this is also non-aromatic. Then we further check the smaller ring, which is nothing but cyclobutadiene. Okay, cyclobutadiene. And this ring is what? It has 4 pi electron, and hence it is anti-aromatic. The whole compound is anti-aromatic in nature with 4 pi electron. That is how we check. We'll see some more examples. Okay, so how many peripheral pi electrons? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 14 pi electrons. So 14 pi electrons is aromatic in nature. Okay, another example, you see, I am giving you some miscellaneous example, mixed all these concepts we have. Okay, so if this molecule goes under any reaction, okay, so you see, first of all, if this pi electron shift over here, okay, then we'll get the negative charge on this carbon atom. So that will be this. CH2. Positive lone pair with negative charge. Okay, now this molecule is having 6 pi electron, 2, 4, 6, and hence it is aromatic in nature. So the product will get according to this shifting of electron. If it shifts here, then we'll have positive charge here, right? Sorry. I made a mistake. I'm sorry. This pi electron should shift here. Then we'll get this. Okay. Negative charge here, and then we get aromatic. If this pi electron shifts here, right, then here we have the positive sign, then this ring has 4 pi electrons, right? So 4 pi electrons means what? It is anti-aromatic. So according to that, we'll not get the major product. Okay, understood. Now one more example, you see, this is the two compounds I have drawn. Suppose this bond is alpha and this bond is beta, right? What we have to compare, the bond order of alpha and bond order of beta, the bond length of alpha and bond length of beta, the bond strength of alpha and the bond strength of beta. All these three things we have to compare. Now you see, there are two possibility here. There are two possibilities. One is what? If this pi electron shifts here, then what happens? If the pi electron shifts here, the compound we get, right? And what happens if the pi electron shifts here, like both way it's, if it shifts, gives you the same product. Okay, so the product here, it will be, we have positive sign, negative and positive with a lone pair, with a lone pair. Now with this shifting, what happens, you see this ring, the larger ring here, it is aromatic 6 pi electron, and this ring has 2 pi electron, right? This is also aromatic. The whole compound is what? It is aromatic in nature. Okay, so this is for the smaller ring. Now here you see this ring has 2 plus 2, 4 pi electron, so this is anti-aromatic. But this ring has 2 pi electron, so it is aromatic, right? So with this shifting, one part is anti-aromatic, other one is aromatic, and here both are aromatic. So if you compare the shifting of this from here to here and here to here, this is more likely to happen comparatively, because we are going towards aromaticity, complete aromaticity, right? It means what? This molecule will exist in this form more, where the bond order of alpha is 1, right? We are comparing these two, okay? So since this is more stable aromaticity, because of aromaticity, so bond order is 1. Here, since half part is anti-aromatic, so this conversion is slightly less. The tendency for this molecule to convert into this is slightly less in comparison to this one. So here the bond order of beta will be slightly more than 1, right? So what we can say, the bond order of beta is more than to that of alpha, and when the bond order is more, bond strength is also more, and when bond strength is more, bond length should be less. So this is the order of these three parameters we have with respect to these two examples. Always remember one thing, this is the comparative study we are doing on, we are doing this, right? Comparative study of these two molecules, bond order of this bond and this bond, we are doing according to the aromatic behavior, okay? So this is it for the, you know, aromatic compounds. Many examples we have seen. You have to keep these examples in mind, because all these are important. What factor we are applying when, and what we do when we have multicyclic system with non-aromaticity or sp3 hybridized carbon, then we'll check further smaller ring, then a smaller ring, and then a smaller ring till we get aromaticity or anti-aromaticity. Okay, so when we have this kind of molecule, you must remember what is the method we have to apply to conclude whether the compound is aromatic or anti-aromatic. Okay, we'll see some examples, some reactions of organic chemistry also, which involves aromaticity. Okay, that we'll see here. Next, friends, before going into the reactions, we'll also see here aromaticity in anilines. Okay, anilines are what? Anilines are these are cyclic conjugated hydrocarbon. For example, the simplest one, if I write, which is cyclobutadiene, right? Cyclic conjugated hydrocarbon. The name of this compound is aniline, and in this bracket we'll write down the number which is equals to the number of carbon atom in the ring. Okay, so 4 carbon atom, so we have 4 over there. If you write down benzene, benzene is also a type of aniline. The another name of benzene will be what? According to this nomenclature, aniline 6, because we have 6 carbon atom present in the ring. Okay, one more example you see. cyclic conjugated system. The name of this compound is aniline 8, since we have 8 carbon atom present here. Okay, so in all these molecule, if you calculate the number of pi electrons, here we have 4 pi electrons. So 4 pi electrons is what? It is anti-aromatic. 4 pi electrons anti-aromatic. Here we have 6 pi electron. 6 pi electron is aromatic. Okay. Here we have 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 pi electrons. So this is anti-aromatic. Okay. Now some more examples we'll see here. This molecule, if you calculate the number of pi electrons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 pi electrons. So 10 pi electrons, according to Huckel's rule, it follows Huckel's rule, n is equal to 2, so it should be aromatic, right? So according to Huckel's rule, it is aromatic in nature, but the actual, you know, the thing is, it is not aromatic, but it is non-aromatic in nature. Right? And why it is non-aromatic? Because of this hydrogen-hydrogen repulsion here. This hydrogen and this hydrogen, here we don't have that much space so that it can accommodate two hydrogen atom here. Right? sp2 hybridize. So this will be in the same plane, then the repulsion between this hydrogen atom will be more, and hence to minimize this repulsion, one of this ring will come out of the plane. Okay, and that is how the molecule becomes non-planar, and non-planar molecule is always non-aromatic, because for aromatic and anti-aromaticity, the condition is what? It is cyclic planar conjugated system. Okay, so it is non-planar, so non-planar becomes non-aromatic. Now you see this example also, if I write down in this way, okay, and with this bond, suppose we have oxygen attached with these two bonds here, right? With this carbon and this carbon is attached with oxygen in this plane. Okay, so we have this ring in one plane, and with these two carbon, oxygen is attached like this, coming out of the plane. Okay, so this becomes what? When this oxygen is attached out of the plane, so this ring becomes planar. We have a double bond like this. So this ring becomes planar, and planar contains 2, 4, 6, 10 electrons, 10 pi electrons. This is what? Aromatic in nature, since it follows Huckel's rule. Okay. Right? So the similar way, if you discuss this also, it is also according to the anti-aromaticity rule that you have, this should also be anti-aromatic in nature. I forgot to discuss this here. Okay, what happens, since we have 8 carbon atoms here, so this molecule also changes its plane and becomes non-planar. Okay, how it becomes non-planar, I'll just, the structure of this molecule is something like this. Is something like this. Okay, and we have alternate double bond, 1, 2, 3, and 4, right? But this molecule, this one is in different plane, this one is in different plane. Okay, so that is why this molecule is also non-aromatic in nature. Non-planar, non-aromatic. So aniline 8 is non-aromatic, it is not anti-aromatic, however it contains 8 pi electrons. Right, non-planar. Another molecule you see, benzene. Benzene, you see, it has 6 pi electrons, and this is aromatic in nature. This triple bond is formed because of hybrid orbital. Here we have hybrid orbital which overlaps and forms this triple bond here. So this one bond we are not counting here. So it contains 6 pi electrons, aromatic in nature. One more example I'll write down. Okay. This molecule, see, it has how many pi electrons? Again, you see, like this triple bond, the one of this double bond will not count. Okay, so we have two double bond here, one pi bond. So we have two pi bonds here, one pi bond will not count. Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 12 pi electrons here. According to this, we have 12 pi electrons. So it should be what? Anti-aromatic. But the actual result, it is not anti-aromatic, but it is non-aromatic in nature. Why? Because the molecule has more than 7 atoms present here, and it changes its plane, becomes non-aromatic. Right? The same thing we have here also, non-aromatic. Okay? So this is how a few examples we have discussed, which is important. See, the aromatic compounds are actually highly stable compounds. Okay? So you see, the stability order, I have also written this, again I am writing it down. Aromatic compounds are highly stable. Because of conjugation and planarity, the molecule gets extra stability. Okay? So this is aromatic compounds, and then non-aromatic compounds are the next stable compound we have. Non-aromatic compounds are actually the simple compounds which is there at the room temperature. Okay? So that's why the stability order is aromatic, non-aromatic, and then the last we have anti-aromatic. Anti-aromatic compounds are highly unstable since it has two unpaired electron present in the molecular orbital. Okay? That's why the order is this. This order is very important. They have asked many times this question. Okay, directly also, and the application of this also. Okay, so must remember this order. Okay, so these are the few examples we have discussed regarding aromaticity, anti-aromaticity and non-aromaticity. We have also learned that how to assign aromatic and anti-aromatic compounds, how do we check, what we have to think, and these examples that we have discussed, if you remember these examples in mind, if you keep on revising this, you will not get any further questions from this. All these examples, if you remember, you can solve all the questions that you get in the exam. Okay? So, coming session, we are going to discuss the reactions which involves aromaticity. Okay?